Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you one more application layer protocol, that is HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. And to understand HTTP protocol, let me tell you how many things that I'm going to cover in this video. See, first I'll be discussing about basics of HTTP protocol. After that, I'll explain you two types of HTTP protocol. One is HTTP 1.0. That is non-persistent connection type of HTTP, and second is HTTP 1.1, that is persistent connection type of HTTP. I'll explain you both of these in great detail, and at last I'm going to explain you HTTP methods. So there are varieties of HTTP methods that I'll explain you by some practical analogy, so that will give you more clarity regarding how HTTP functions. So let us see first basics of HTTP protocol. See, HTTP means Hypertext Transfer Protocol. You will be observing sometimes there can be HTTPS. This S is there for security. See, when you browse website normally like Wikipedia, in that there will be HTTP protocol only. But when you enter user ID, password kind of things, at that time you need to have security. At that time there can be HTTPS protocol, which you will be observing in your web browser. Right, so HTTP is having two versions, HTTP and HTTPS. HTTPS, that is there along with security. Here with HTTP protocol, port number is 8080. You need to remember this. Sometimes that question comes in competitive examination. What is the port number of HTTP protocol? That is 80, right? Port number is having size of 16 bits. So with 16 bits, representation is there. And that value is 80. At transport layer, HTTP usually uses TCP for reliable services. In majority of website access, you need to have reliable connection. And to have reliable connection, we usually use TCP protocol at transport layer. It is not mandatory you will have to use TCP protocol, but usually in website access, you need to have reliable connection. In that situation, you should not have any corrupted data. That's why for reliable services, TCP is there at transport layer along with HTTP at application layer. Let me give you one analogy how HTTP functions. See, here we are having client and here we are having server. This server belongs to Google and this client could be anyone, right? Now if client is writing HTTP and then www.google.com, then this client will be requesting server. Client will be requesting server. And once server sees the request of this client, server will reply back. Right? Server will reply back. So based on request and reply, data exchange that will happen. Based on request and reply, data exchange in between client and server that will happen. Why I'm telling you this? The reason is, you need to understand state of server and state of client. So here client is requesting for web page and server is replying back based on request of client. Here port number for HTTP will be 8080, right? Now here very interesting thing that comes, you see, server stays stateless. Server stays stateless. Why? The reason is there can be so many clients. Like if you observe, here this server of Google may be connected with so many clients, right? There can be so many clients connected with this server. So as if server is keeping track of all the clients, then this server needs higher computational power. For example, if you talk about Google server, millions of people are connected at the same time. So if Google is keeping track of state of all the clients, then Google needs to have so much computational power. Right. So here in majority of cases, you'll be observing server stays stateless. So server stays stateless means there are many clients connected with server. So the server cannot maintain the state of each client. Right. While you will be observing, this client state is maintained using cookies. So whenever you browse anything, there will be cookies that is there with your computer. Right. Cache memory that is there with our computer, that will be immediately fetching all the cookies given by server. And based on cookies, your client will be maintaining the state. So client will be stateful. This client that will be stateful. Client will be having idea about what is, what are the state which is there with server. Like server is busy or not. What data that server has given in last request. Right. So all the state that is there with client which is stored inside cookies. Right. Cookies are stored in temporary data inside your computer. So here client state that is maintained using cookies. See, HTTP is in-band protocol. Now what is the meaning of in-band protocol? See, here command and data are there on same connection. So here we are having, let us assume here we are having TCP connection. So in TCP connection, when client is requesting for something, at that time command and data both are there on same connection. That's why HTTP, that is referred as in-band protocol. Right. Now I'm going to explain you types of HTTP protocol. So in general, there are two types. Earlier version, that was HTTP 1.0, that was non-persistent connection. Right. Non-persistent connection means what? See, TCP connection is established for each HTTP request response transaction. Right. And after server sends the response back to client, connection is closed from the side of server. If client needs to make another request, then it has to establish new TCP connection. So here I have told you, see, client is receiving data based on request reply, right? So as if client is forwarding request, server will reply back and server will close the connection over here in non-persistent connection. And if client wants another data, then client will, before client forward another request, client will have to make sure there is a connection establishment as per TCP. Right. After that, only request can be forwarded. So HTTP 1.0, that was older version in which there was non-persistent connection. So with every request response transaction, there was connection closed, and for new transaction of request response, there has to have connection establishment again. That was the case that which was happening previously. Nowadays in 2023, we are using persistent connection. See, with non-persistent connection, if you see the major points, then you can say simple implementation is there and predictable resource usages that will be there in between client and server. Why? The reason is here server will be terminating that connection. That's why predictable resources usages will be there. But here, as we need to establish connection again as per three-way handshake using TCP, you will be increasing overhead. And because of increase in overhead, there will be higher latency, right? If you talk about current scenario, then in that we are using HTTP 1.1 in 2023, where we have persistent connection. Now let me explain you what is the meaning of persistent connection. See, the client and server maintains the connection open after initial request response exchange. So here there is no close in connection. Initially there will be connection establishment. After that, response request exchange will happen. But after that also, they will keep their connection open. They will not terminate it. So for a new request by client, there is no need to establish new TCP connection. And as we don't need to have new TCP connection, here we will be reducing overhead and there will be faster response time. So nowadays you will be observing almost all the people are using high speed internet, in which you don't have this facility, right? Non-persistent. Few older websites are using still non-persistent connection, but those older websites that nobody is using nowadays. If you talk about new generation internet connection, in that majority of people are using persistent connection, in that we don't need to have connection termination. Server and client, they will keep their connection open. So as if client is asking for request, immediately response will be given back, right? So there will be reduction in overhead and faster response time will be there. Now I'm going to explain you HTTP methods. So there are some varieties of HTTP methods that I'll be discussing by some basic examples. Like first one is get. See, the get method that is used to retrieve data from the server. So as if you want to retrieve data from the server, get method that is used along with HTTP. See, head is similar to get method, but it requests only the headers of the resource and not the actual content. See, in metadata, we use this head, right? In metadata, you don't need to have all the datas. You will be asking for headers only. From headers, you can understand how data is there, right? So get, that we use it to take data, or you can say retrieve data from the server, and head, that we use it to have headers from the server, that you can say, and that typically we use it in metadata, right? See, post is used in filling forms on the server. In the post method, client fills the form back to the server. So on server, if you want to fill any form, then form filling, that we do it on server using post method, right? Next is put. See, put method, that we use it to upload object on the server. Object could be anything, like it could be video file, audio file, image file, right? It could be any file. And to upload file on the server, we use put method. Next is delete. See, delete method, that we use it to request removal of object on the server. So as if you want to remove any object on the server, then you can place delete method. Like if I have uploaded any video on YouTube, and as if I want to delete that video, then I'll be using delete method, in which I'll be requesting YouTube by clicking on delete button. So once YouTube sees my request, it will be deleting it. But it is not like I can delete other people's video, right? In that, YouTube observes authenticity and all those things. If I'm deleting my video, then only YouTube will allow me to delete it, right? See, connect method, that is used by HTTPS for secure connection, right? So connect method, that we use it with HTTPS for secure connection. See, option method, that is used to request information about the communication options available with particular URL. So whenever you are accessing any URL, and as if you want to see how many communication options are available, to see that, option method that we use, right? Next is trace method. Trace method, that is used to see intermediary nodes, right? So as if you want to see what are the intermediary nodes in between connection, right? Then we will be using trace method. And last one is patch method. The patch method, that is used to apply partial modification to the resources. So as if you want to modify any resources, then you will have to use patch method. For example, if you have some file in which you just want to do modification, then partial modification, that we can do it with the use of patch method. So these are the methods that is available with HTTP, and by those methods we are practically accessing websites on internet. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in the comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.